So, my last video on Idaten received quite a few dislikes, and with good reason. The video was not only poorly made and rushed, but also wasn't comprehensive as the show hadn't fully aired. A lot can change in the last few episodes, and it helped me realize I was wrong in my first video. Therefore, I'm making this one to cut my losses. Idaten is nowhere near being a bad anime, as it's completely abhorrent. Before you click off, let me elaborate. Idaten is a dark comedy shonen fight anime with a fantasy setting. The story revolves around demons and gods, where the gods had sealed away the demons 800 years ago. But now, without the seal breaking, demons have returned, and it is up to the Idaten deities to protect humanity's extinction from demonic oppression. Our main lead is an ambitious, power-seeking god named Hayato. He has his mentor Rin, who not only is the one who summoned him, but also the one who trains him. We have others supporting Idaten as well. Easley, Prontea, Paula, and others who are summoned later on. The demons, the antagonists of the Idaten, are servants of the demon lord Over M, who is a mysterious incognito figure who uses a robotic old man body to speak and interact with others. The demons are indebted to him for giving them human forms and aid him in his endeavors. So far, this sounds like a pretty compelling setup, but my true disappointment lies in, well, everything else. We have witnessed the interesting part. Now it all goes downhill. How do you destroy such a strong foundation like this? Well, it was destroyed to begin with. Stay with me, friends, as I continue. To me, it appears Amahara, the author of this story, was nowhere near prepared enough to account for all the complications and issues that having a main cast of gods could produce. And we see this in the form of massive plot dumps in every episode, oversimplification of combat, and 4D chess contrasting with a satirical presentation. Unlike in Death Note, where 4D chess level big brain complexity is welcome, Idaten uses 4D chess to elaborate and patch up plot holes in the otherwise nonsensical plot. Some would say this show is not to be taken seriously and be comedic, but this doesn't explain why they take their plot direction so seriously. Oh, because it wouldn't make sense any other way. Amahara wrote himself into a hole by making all these characters so above human limitations, where easily everything could fall apart if he doesn't take limiting precautions in his narrative. We see this with these super long, quote-unquote, comedic fast-forwarding scenes, where they elaborate on world mechanics or plans against the enemy. I believe this was a joke the first time, but the second, third, fourth, this is no joke. It was something much more eerie. Instead of feeling like a running gag in the show, this now became a cry for help in a way for the pacing. Without these fast-forwarding scenes, they would have to spend whole episodes without conflict. Which is something I guess they just didn't want to present. Another thing they didn't care to present was giving the Idaten something special or memorable in the sense of combat. Hayato's big, special, quirky main character trait is being able to punch stuff. Something I have never seen before in any anime. About halfway into the show, he gains a special power-up from training. Guess what it was? Even stronger punches that hurt more. The demons have more unique methods of combat than the literal gods, and it makes the whole spectacle of combat the show's centered around feel less exciting and more boring than anything. Hayato does punch, Rin does cut, Easley does thought, Prontea has magic, but is never on the screen. Paula literally doesn't fight at all, Gil gets raped, so they only spend their time on the characters who have painfully uninteresting combat features. At this point, we know the pacing and combat are lacking. But there's more. What about the characters' personalities, goals, and motivations? Well, they are gods, so this gives you the chance to do anything, right? Complete creative freedom to express any personality you would have ever hoped for, right, Amahara? No. Hayato's only true motivation is to get strong. Get strong to be strong. Easley has every goal and motivation the story needs him to have for it to progress. Rewire brain, do international affairs, needs to plan a strategy to wipe out all the enemy forces. There's Easley. Then we get Paula, who has nothing special about her other than looking pretty and wanting to fight demons. Same deal for Prontea. Actually, same deal for everyone else good. What about the baddies? Well, we get Over M, who wants to war with the other countries for some reason and used a demon-run Nazi army to do it. And there you go. All the bad guys think and behave how he wants them to. Only Emperor Takeshita had any complexity, but then again, not when it mattered. Everyone else is just some small trope or meme that is given power and authority, and they fight the Idaten for his sake. These demons just do what they need to do. The only difference is the humor between them, if you'd even call it that, and their method they go about servicing their lord. The way you can service your lord is by hitting the like button and subscribing to my channel. Yeah. Anyways, so then bad guys plot and scheme while the good guys plot and scheme while Hayato trains, while Hayato gets brutalized, while the demons plot and the allies scheme while easily researches, while the bad guys scheme until one party commits to something drastic which starts a fight. This wouldn't be all bad, but combine it with the aforementioned horrible pacing and underwhelming characters, it becomes a serious drag. Example. In this episode, we have 15 minutes of elaboration. In a show where you condition the viewers to want to see flashing colors and fanservice, you've given them this? I don't even have a problem with this inherently. Vinland Saga has episodes without combat and it's a very decent show. But I expect that from Vinland, because they set themselves up as a story with intricacy and to be taken seriously. Not Idaten. The whole show is a joke. From the character design, to the world, to how they resolve things instantly, it's meant to be funny. Why do all this? It makes the show flow horribly, like you went from swimming in a lake to swimming in Also, I know comedy is subjective and all, but there is a limit. I counted how many times I laughed throughout this show. And it was 3 times. Once in episode 2, once when Merku said something funny here, and here when Takeshita talked about his sex life. For a dark comedy, laughing 3 times is very rough. I lost track of the amount of times I cringed when I watched this. The number got too high, so I had to abandon that idea. Now we get into my favorite segment, quirky creative details. We can start with the details I thought worked as a positive. Number 1. I loved seeing Hayato in pain. I hated him very much, so this was quite satisfying. Number 2. I enjoyed how they turned most of the bad guys good. It is fun to see the hated characters stripped of their empty, meaningless identities into an even more hollow husk. Number 3. There was one good fight scene between Hayato and the Emperor. Oh, they skipped through it the moment it escalated? Never mind, I take that one back. Number 3. Again. I thought the concept of the one who summoned the god having an influence on their personality was pretty interesting. I hope a better show steals that idea in the future. Now for creative decisions that heavily bothered me. Number 1. The pseudo-social commentary. Unlike intellectual works, Idaten's social mirrors and portrayals feel like the author projected something so obviously that it comes off as cringe. Not hit it in the slightest, and even then feels like a middle schooler's take on humanity and social issues. But it had to be, because the target audience for Idaten is involuntarily celibate simpletons. Number 2. Something I love is that the author does the masterful writing skill called tell, don't show. There is nothing to ponder when watching. Everything you need to know, they will tell you straight up. It's okay, you can shut off your brain. Don't think, why would you think? That's not needed, right? Number 3. The fact that Sadabail was a super original religious country and totally not just parroting played out evil Catholicism tropes. They really could have done anything they wanted to, but instead chose an already pre-made religion because they were lazy. What's the funny, easy religion to talk about that's covered in my history book? Number 4. I know they explain it in the show, but just think about this in concept. The idea that Idaten gods look like normal teens dressed super casually is extremely unremarkable and boring. Number 5. Zobel being a generic ripoff of any totalitarian government is also lazy. Amahara could have done crazy stuff here, made a theoretical oppressive dominant military with original designs and concepts. Nope. Just stole it from history. Why? Because why try? That's a recurring problem with this show. Number 6. The pure idea that Idaten are just now learning magic despite being alive for so long is just silly and I refuse to even recognize it. It's so dumb. Number 7. The final number. The constant sexualization of young boys by Miku and other demons is truly despicable.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
And the fact that they are villain characters does not change this. Who even thinks about this stuff? Oh, a degenerate who should be cancelled. But that won't happen, so who cares? It would be fine if this just stopped with one haha joke. But in order to make more demons, Merku and Miku have to literally have sex and breed with children demons in human bodies just to make more of them. We're talking beyond toddler-con stuff right here. This is inexcusable. Oh, and bonus, the Crunchyroll comments section is very degenerate. After that creative decision, I believe we should be ready for my final verdict. If you don't think this show is skippable by now, you might need therapy. If you have any self-respect, do not watch this anime. If you think it is good after all I said, you are a degenerate and the door is right there. Go on. Hey, and don't come back.
Hey there. Don't you just hate people like that? Who berate on what makes others happy? Come, sit. Let's have some moonshine. Oh, I don't want you to feel pressured to say anything or do anything. Trust me, I won't find it awkward. Just relax. You don't have to worry about anything ever again. Because Noko can't hurt you here. This land belongs to people like me and you. A safe space to keep us from the oppression of the outright belligerent contrarians. Though I do have one thing to say. That Idaten anime was pretty shit.